So this is specifically for courses. So yeah, it's just something that I discovered, and it's one of the requests of my client. She want me to make the courses in order by prices, and she also want me to remove some styling of the preset template from Learnworlds. So yeah, I just want to show with you how that works. Probably you also have that problem. So without further ado, let's begin. 1, 2, 3. So first is we need to log into our Learnworlds account. Okay, I'm gonna log in there. And you will see here, like we have the courses options. Now the old one was, it was set, I mean the prices was randomly not in order. So like the 995 here was in there, and then the 695 was in there, and then the 1295 was in the middle. And the owner of this school wanted me to make it sorted by price. So it should be the cheapest to the expensive one. So how did it able to fix that? So if you're concerned with that, you can just go into the courses and then course manager, and then in the course manager, this will be the placement of your courses in order. So I've set this in essentials because basically what was the problem is, let's say, let me just show with you. So let's say this one, essentials. So the problem before is I set, let's say, the essentials, I put it in there. So if I go here and then if I refresh this one, and let's try to refresh the page, the pages is not in order. So basically something like this, like this one is in the middle, it should supposed to be in the left part, and the essentials should be on the last part. Okay, so if you want to make your courses carousel in order, just go to the course manager and set your placement according to what you preferred. Okay, now the next thing we will do is, okay, it's already back to normal. Though the next thing as well is this course panel. So this is not the default style in course panel, so I minify it. So I remove some of the options that is in default. So how you can do that? Okay, I'm gonna log into the editor and go to the, okay, this is the editor mode. So what I did here, by the way, this is a, if you want to choose this one, the type of that course, the type of that module is courses. So this one, products, okay, the products section. Now the product section, like this is how it looks if you set it by default. So they will see as the sneak peek of your products. So something, let's say, like, and then you can choose like what will be, you need to select for the course. So let's say you want the social influencer visible, then this will be they will see the breakdown of your courses. Okay, now if this is too thin for you, you can go to the layout section. I'm sorry, you need to open, you need to press, you need to configure the section instead of the module. So press the outer, click the outer part of the layer, and then go to the layouts, and then there is an options in here if you want to make the height extra long or just small, and then if you want it to be narrow or full. Okay, now in these options, like say, I mean, let's say I'm gonna remove this, I'm gonna make this, hold on, let me just put that into normal. So let's say I don't want to see all of the stumps in here, or I don't want to see these check marks. I just want to see like the elements. So what you can do is press the module, and then there is sections in here called appearance, and then you can just hide the indicators. As you notice in here, there is a check marks. Check marks means I already went to that pages, so I'm already enrolled in that pages. So you can disable that indicator. You can also disable like the video duration if you don't want the ebook reading time, PDF, or consumers numbers. Okay. Also, like if you want to remove this numbering, you can also set that like that if you want it to be minimal. So in here, if you check this page that I created, this course thing I created, I remove all of this options. Before it was like this, like that. And my client doesn't want this check mark to be visible, and it looks like the styling is not properly right. So you can just disable that one, or there is also an options. Let me just delete this first. I'm gonna delete this one. So if you are really particular with the the styling of this, there is an options in here. Like if you click this one, okay, there is an options in here to edit the course. So just click this one. It means course custom code. And let's say you don't want to insert the CSS code, or you don't want to integrate the CSS code in all of your pages. You just want it to be integrated into a specific element. Then you can do that like this. Okay, for the HTML. So it's basically like, let me just open this one, select elements, and let's say I'm gonna change this presentation, let's say this one, presentation to build. So this one, let's say I'm gonna change the color, let's say I'm gonna add a style. So for example, this is just a sample, okay, so color red. Let me grab that because we will remove that bit later. So update, as you can see here, it's turned red. So that's how it works. So I'm gonna remove the red again in here. Control F. Where is it? I need to remove that back. Sorry. So this one, go back to the extensions, use code, selected elements, and let's remove back the red under the presentation, remove. You can also add classes if you want to. So that's basically how you can style your elements. Okay, so if you also want to know about Learnworlds Builder, I have the tutorial for you in that. I'm gonna put it on the link description below or in here. So that's it, guys. I hope you learned something on this video. I know that that's quite simple, but it's just something that I came up with. Like, I think I need to film this out because I was really having problem lately. So that's it, guys.